Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sandeep Gautey. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel English Guru for All. In this video lesson, we are going to discuss the most important aspect of body language, that is gesture and posture. Actually, I mention all the aspects here, but I am going to take these two simultaneously so you can understand both, you can say, at the same level. This is the most important aspect of non-verbal communication. These are the technical terms, means gesture and posture. Now, what is the meaning of gesture? It means how you use your body parts or movements of body parts in the communication process. For example, you please stand up. Right now, I am doing what? I am instructing someone, you please stand up, and at the same time, I am using my hand to show that person, you please stand up. It means I am using my body part, and that is nothing but a kind of gesture. Now, what is the meaning of posture? How you hold your whole body in particular situation, that is called what? Posture. Do not get confused, because in gesture we use only body parts to convey the message, and what about posture? We hold complete body, or someone holds complete or whole body in particular situation. Now let me give you some examples so you can understand it. Suppose you are raising your index finger. In that case, what is the meaning of that? You are trying to seek the attention of someone. So the meaning of this particular gesture is to seek attention. What does it mean? To seek attention of someone. What is the example of posture? If you are delivering, you can say, a lecture in the classroom. Right now, I am delivering, I am discussing the topic, gesture and posture with you all. Now, if I stand like this, so it indicates what? How I hold this particular body in this situation, and that is nothing but the example of what? Posture. Now, I am going to write over here, in formal communication, you are going to use appropriate postures, and they are very important there. Now, another example for what? Simultaneously, I am discussing the examples of gesture as well as posture, so you can understand them at the same time. Next example is what? Thumbs up. If you are doing this one, it indicates what? Best of luck. Yes or no? It also indicates what? Well done. So it may indicate you one well done, or you can say best of luck. So this is the example of what? Gesture. But in informal situations, your posture can be different. So you may not be, you can say, utilizing particular kind of posture in informal communication. Suppose you are watching television at your home. At that time, you are not going to use, you can say, even that kind of clothing, means what? Formal one and sitting properly, and today I am going to watch this particular program on the television. What I mean to say, you are going to be in a relaxed mood and you are going to keep your posture according to that. But basically we are talking here about what? Formal communication, and posture should be used according to situation. Already everything depends upon what? All types of body language, you can say, what aspects of body language. We need to consider what? Context. In each and every. And according to context, the meaning of gesture as well as posture may change. Hope you are getting what I mean to say. Another example of what gesture is handshake. What is that? Handshake. It indicates what? It indicates friendship. Yes. That is also a kind of, you can say what? Meaning that can be conveyed with the help of this particular gesture. Now, one more example I would like to give. If you want to say yes, sir, in that case, automatically you are going to use or you are going to nod your head to indicate what? To say yes, sir. So these are the examples of what? Gesture. Already I explained even what is the meaning of posture. All they have to use properly in the communication process because they may influence your communication process. If you are using inappropriate gesture or posture in particular situation, it may have some kind of negative impact on the receivers. Even I observe so many people around me, they are using what? Excessive use of body language. Right now, I am before you, I am using what? Controlled body language. If I am doing like this, today we are going to talk about that is what aspects of body language, all I have written on the blackboard. Definitely my body language may distract you. And that is why we should utilize this one in balanced way. Hope your concept of gesture and posture is clear. And in the next video lesson, we are going to talk about dress and physical appearance. Thank you. Thank you so much.